Ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the last demand of your 8-point demands, including the other ones that you've not written here. Let me at this juncture thank you most sincerely and most respectfully on behalf of the Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and on behalf of the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the Indian National Assembly for being a responsible corporate organization that takes, you know, the progress of this country so seriously, to the extent that you abandoned all your personal engagements, you know, to come to the gates of National Assembly and press for this demand for almost 3 days. The Senate views that as, you know, one of the processes of entrenching our nascent democracy. The only thing we frown at is the fact that while you were doing that, you blocked the entrances of National Assembly, and that brought us maybe it kind of reawakens us that where somebody's right starts, another person's right ends. So while you have a right to demonstrate any time you so wish to this National Assembly, because this is the symbol of democracy, we implore you, not only you, but because of the reach you have in this country, to lead by example, by telling people that henceforth, any demonstrator coming to National Assembly should find a place, you know, to display his displeasure, display his grievances, but without necessarily blocking the entrance. That kind of attitude is very, very risky, even for all of us. We never know what can happen, God forbid. If there is any emergency and the people block entrance, anybody, you know, the consequences can only be imagined or can be better imagined. So we thank you so much for that protest, and we thank you for the time you've given us today with my colleagues, although it has taken too long a time, but it is worth going through, because I'm sure as you leave this National Assembly today, you are going to leave it, you know, changed by people, you know, with better perspective on how we run the business, you know, of this institution. And we also understand you better today. If somebody should ask us who are Occupy or Limited, we will be able to say, yes, this is their mission. Contrary to what maybe people have been saying also about you, whatever you say about us, people also say about you, they say about him and her and anywhere. Our people say, when you point an accusing finger on somebody, three. Of fingers are pointing at you. A lot of people used to say, when they see people protesting, say, they are paid hired agents, they are here to make noise. But today, Nigerians would know you are not part of that pack. At least we can attribute faces to who you are. Today you are here, she is here, she is here, she is here, she. If you are hired, I don't think you would bother yourself to show your faces. Mm-hmm. So this is a commendable effort, and we encourage you to go out, use this knowledge that we have shared today, this interaction, educate Nigerians on what constituency project is like, for instance, on what this allowances of members of National Assembly is. You can, like, for this severance allowance, go back, look at it. How did you arrive at this 36 million naira you are saying about? Is it possible for somebody to be paid severance allowance every month? You know, 7 million every month. What is severance allowance? I'm sure you are better educated. So we are not saying that we should not be criticized, and we are not saying that we are absolute or we are right in all circumstances. We are human beings. As an institution, we can make mistakes. As individuals, we can make mistakes. But we want to be criticized for what we have done, like we have heard from you today, that, okay, you have done this, we agree on this, but so thing needs to be done in the proper manner. So please, tell people to criticize us. We are their representative, but they should criticize us on what we have done wrong, not what somebody perceived. I contested election with somebody, he lost. He wants to bring me down at all costs. He wants to come back, or he wants to come to this institution. The only way he can do it is to tell the people that I'm collecting so much money and I'm building houses. And the people take it. Next election, they push me aside, bring him, only for him to come and start giving them excuses that I didn't know this thing is like this until when I come. He is already there. And this institution respects experience. World over, if you go to the United States, you meet a senator that spends 40 years in the Senate. 40! And that gives him some exclusive rights. If you change him, like if the people, McCain, is representing, change him and bring in a new senator, he cannot be chairman of defense committee. And being chairman of defense committee gives you leverage, you know, to do so many things internationally. So we encourage communities to, as much as possible, try to bring back members more and more, because as they are coming more and more, they are learning more and more. But that is not to say that they cannot be changed. So if you go and find out that these things that they are supposed to do, like this constituency project, now that you are educated, yes, our member has not been performing. So we want to change him, and we are changing him on good reasons. These are the reasons. I'm sure people will respect you more. Not just change him for the change sake. Yes, but he is not doing so. So-so person has done well. You eulogize him. Come here, tell the world that so-so member or so-so senator has done so very well. We were in his constituency, we saw what he did. That will encourage others to do so. Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you so much. And I look forward to meeting you anywhere, any day, on any issue, you know, because this interactive session is truly entertaining and educating. I have learned a lot from you too, and I'm sure you have learned a lot from us. So as you go back to where you came from, I wish you journey masses, you know, back to our respective destinations. And I want to use this medium, lastly, to tell you that we are floating another organization of Occupy the Occupier. Thank you so much.
thank you very much, Senator.
My brothers. So I don't know.
We have to report back to our people.
Okay. Yeah, you are reporting already. 24/7. Since you started, you have.
Exactly. They know. They know. So they'll have everything.
In prayer. I don't know. You would give us more time. Maybe I see these people. I pray. Then I find out if the Senate President is around. Maybe you pay him a courtesy call. If he's not around, we can say bye bye.
Okay, sir.
What do you say? Or at least we can have a group photograph.
Yes. So we're going to need someone else to take the photograph.